tell us a little bit about your role in the film and also what makes this such a unique project?
Well, first of all, the film is really interesting because it takes place in two parallel universes. There's the contemporary adaptation, which is juxtaposed with images from the folk story. So I got to play two characters. And we actually approached it like two different films. We shot the contemporary. I actually prepped for both simultaneously, then we shot the contemporary, then we took a 4-month break, pre-produced the period bits and shot those. So it was a very consuming process, amazing to play two different people. I kind of feel like the contemporary character is a young boy on his way to becoming a man. Period character is a man, you know, and I got to embody both of those in my early 20s, so it was amazing. Yeah.
How is it to see your brother perform his debut performance?
I'm looking forward to it right now. I haven't actually seen the film as yet, but I'm looking forward to watching it.
That's so exciting. Yeah. So what do you think an international audience should expect from this film?
It's going to be a visual spectacle because I've worked with Rakesh Mehra on two out of his three films. And he is a master craftsman and he's a great director and he takes out great performance. The music is spectacular. And it'll have a great story. It's written by Gulzar. He's one of the most fantastic writers India has ever produced. He's a living legend. So I'm looking forward to so that the world sees the kind of talent India has.
And what do you think the essence of a Bollywood film is?
Joy and colour.
And can I ask, what are you up to at the moment?
Well, right now, my film just released this year. I'm looking forward to starting a new one. I'm taking a bit of a break right now.
Feels, I feel I'm very, very fortunate.
Yeah.
That God has given me this, and life has given me this opportunity. Let me be very, straightforward and say, life has given me an opportunity that I have gone through my career and then I went and, saw all the ups and downs. And then my daughter started her career and she's doing so well. And she went through all kinds of success and few failures also, but more success.
Yeah.
And now my son's being launched, and it's his debut film. And his debut film is at the BFI,
yeah.
London Film Festival. And I came here 7 years back or 8 years back for Slumdog Millionaire. And I felt it was like a dream come true. And it happened to me after almost 25 years. And it's happened to him in the first film. So he couldn't ask for anything better than this. So I'm very, very happy. I'm very excited. I'm very proud of him. I'm proud of the film. And I'm proud of the filmmaker and the entire team. I think this is a film which I think will resonate for many, many years, and it's got very long legs. This film will be remembered for the music, for the beauty, for the performances. It's timeless, the film. It's storytelling. I think all over the world, it's all about storytelling. I think all over the world, it might be Hollywood, might be Bollywood. You have to tell stories. And how you say it, it's all depends on the filmmakers also, how they want to tell their stories. And Rakesh Om Prakash Mehra, I think the way he tells his stories, I think has a certain global appeal. So when you see the film, I think people will, anybody from anywhere in the world, he might be from any country, any religion, he'll be able to relate to his films. His films in the past also have resonated. His films have been, have been Indian entry to the Oscar. His film has been nominated for the BAFTA. So he's a very, very one of our biggest filmmakers and most admired and respected filmmakers of our country.
And how do you feel having Indian cinema being celebrated internationally and at the London Film Festival?
I think about time. It's about time it was celebrated, and I think we deserve it. Yeah.